I just got this end pared down, and I just did this with my big hand plane and then my block plane, so I haven't even sanded this yet, but I just wanted to show you that, you know, I didn't know what else to, I didn't think there was any real other option to use to cut this away, even though it was kind of a lot, but I want to show you, I'm going to cut the other side and show you that it's really pretty reasonable and within our power to do it really quickly with a hand plane and do it safely and accurately. So, you know, I can come back in and sand this when I sand the fronts here and make sure everything is just perfect. But, you know, that's not that bad to do it with a hand plane. I thought about trying to cut some of this off with a Japanese saw, but I just didn't want to run the risk of lashing into this with the coarse teeth of the Japanese saw, you know, because the saw that I have is really pretty aggressive. And so I just didn't want to run that risk. So I'm going to get quite a bit of blade out here to start to really just kind of power through this. Well, you can see, you know, it doesn't take much. Oh, you know, the grain I think is running the wrong. Well, the grain didn't run in the wrong way. I'm cutting it the wrong way. But I looked at it and I thought I was cutting it in the right direction. It's one of those cases where you think you're sighting it. Let me start taking a little bit of blade in now. I need to stay this way and angle away in case I catch it. Not quite ready for the block plane yet. Let me take a little bit more off. Stop being quite such a maniac. Okay, I'm going to sand the rest of this. This just feels a little weird, like this corner is kind of sticking up here a little bit. And I don't want to tear a hunk off. Yeah, I need to just sand that down. But that got most of it.